Welcome to my channel Lenovit. Today we will going to discuss about the boundaries, the contents and the floor of the femoral triangle. The femoral triangle, that is a triangle shape or a wedge shape area between the muscles of the thigh, is formed between the abdominal part and the lower limb. This femoral triangle having certain boundaries and it is separated from the pelvic area towards the thigh muscles. At the level of a lower limb muscles, mostly at the level of the leg, this femoral triangle is continuous with the adductor canal, that is the continuation of the femoral triangle. Now coming to the contents and the boundaries of the femoral triangle. The base of a femoral triangle is formed from the inguinal ligament, continues from the anterior superior iliac spine of the hip bone towards the pubic symphysis. This inguinal ligament is forming the base of the femoral triangle. Then comes the lateral border. This lateral border is formed from a very long or the strap-like muscle that we call as the sartorius. That is a major flexor of the thigh. This sartorius forms the lateral boundary of the femoral triangle, while that of the adductor longus, that is a medial rotator of the thigh, is going to form the medial boundary of the femoral triangle. When these both muscles are going to merge at the apex of a triangle, there is a continuation to the adductor canal. Now coming to the floor of the femoral triangle. First, we have to know the floor is formed from the two major muscles, that including the pectineus and the adductor longus muscle. This adductor longus that is forming the lateral wall of the femoral triangle is also contributing to the floor of the femoral triangle. Now coming to the contents of the femoral triangle. Now here you can see I have drawn a diagram to make you guys easy and better explain about the area of the pelvic region and how this is continued. Retention of the arteries, vein of the femoral region. The contents coming from lateral to medial include the larger muscle, that is the iliopsoas muscle. This iliopsoas muscle is a major flexor of a hip joint, and this iliopsoas is going to form the lateral boundary of the floor of the femoral triangle. Coming to the medial of the iliopsoas muscle is the presence of a femoral nerve. This nerve is going to pass from the femoral triangle and it is going to supply many of the muscles of the thigh, including the flexors muscle of the thigh and mostly the abductors or the medial or lateral rotators. Now these two muscles are not included in a content that we call as the femoral sheet. The femoral sheet we are going to discuss later, but we have to know that these femoral iliopsoas muscle and the femoral nerve are excluded from the femoral sheet. Then coming to the more medially is a couple of nerve vessels and the lymphatic, and this vasculature is covered by a sheet that we call as a femoral sheet. And this femoral sheet, here you can see this femoral sheet having the three structures inside it, including laterally the femoral artery, that is the continuation of the external iliac artery superior to the femur bone. And this external iliac artery will going to continue as a femoral artery in the femoral triangle, and then it continue in the adductor canal as a popliteal artery. The second component from lateral to medial in the femoral sheet is the femoral vein. This femoral vein is ultimately the continuation of the popliteal vein, that is coming from the inferior knee joint area or from the popliteal fossa that we have discussed in a separate video. Now the femoral vein is going to form the somewhat medial boundary of the femoral sheet. Now medial to the femoral vein and the femoral artery, or you can say the most medial thing, is the femoral ring. This femoral ring or the femoral canal is an area where there is a passage of a lymphatic vessel. This lymphatic vessel is most medial and it forms medially towards the femoral vein, and it is also a content of the femoral sheet. So these three contents from lateral to medial include the femoral artery, femoral vein and the lymphatic is forming the femoral sheet, or also called as the femoral fascia. Then comes the opening through the femoral triangle. These including the femoral vein and and the lymphatic vessel is going to pass from an opening that we call as the saphenous opening into the lower limb. And there's a continuation of the femoral vein and the lymphatic into the lower limb as the saphenous opening. So this was the general explanation about the boundaries, about the contents, and about the facial sheet of the femoral triangle. I hope you will be explained well. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more.